What would Earth be like if it were outside the habitable zone? The Earth's orbit around our sun lies within the habitable zone of our solar system. This means the temperatures are correct for us to live here. They're not too cold or too hot. But what would happen if the Earth were outside that zone? Could life exist on Earth if we were outside of the habitable zone? Let's find out. Closer to the sun. If the Earth were closer to the sun, only 1%, it would be warmer. The average temperature at the Earth's surface is about 15 degrees Celsius, 59 degrees Fahrenheit. If we were closer to our star, that temperature would rise significantly. This would be one of the worst scenarios, since the increase in temperature would cause a large part of the water in the air, oceans, and rivers to evaporate due to the increase in temperature, making life difficult for organisms like us, which depend on water to survive. The temperature of our planet depends on its distance from the sun and how much energy from that star reaches it every day. If it were closer, life would be much more difficult, if not impossible. In this scenario, the Earth's poles would melt at a more amazing speed, which would heat the ocean's water, causing substantial natural disasters, mainly floods and hurricanes of magnitudes never seen before. Hurricanes are formed by the difference in pressures and temperatures in the atmosphere, and one of their primary functions is to dissipate excess heat in the air. Hurricanes would be much more frequent and devastating with a hotter planet and higher temperatures. An increase in temperature would also cause many plants and animals to become extinct, especially insects and algae, since they are the most sensitive to changes in temperature. This would cause an imbalance in the food chain, which would directly impact agriculture and the food supply for the whole world. Further from the sun. If you're wondering what Earth would be like if it were 1% further away from the sun, let's look at how temperatures would change. In this scenario, our planet would be 4% cooler than it is now. The average temperature would drop from 14 degrees Celsius or 57 degrees Fahrenheit to 12 degrees Celsius or 53 degrees Fahrenheit. If you live in a tropical area where a cold climate is not typical, this will bring significant changes that would cause the temperature to drop and completely change the appearance of the Earth. Under these conditions, the polar caps would increase in size, extending beyond their customary borders and bringing cold air masses to the most equatorial and tropical zones. This temperature change would also cause the areas closest to the North and South poles to freeze solid for most of the year, except for a few weeks or days during the summer. Life in these areas of the Earth would be much more complicated than it already is. The only good news would be for tropical areas such as the Central American countries and the areas near the equator, since the temperatures would drop in these places and there would no longer be sweltering heat. Instead, there would be a warmer and more pleasant climate. Effects on human life. Climate change would have a direct effect on human life. The impact would depend on where you live and how prepared you were for it. If you were living in an area that was not well suited for agriculture, or if your food supply depended upon imported goods, like the United States, then there would be significant problems with hunger. On the other hand, if your region had always been able to grow its crops and had never relied on imports, the problems might not be so drastic. Agriculture. Agriculture is one area where we could see significant changes in our lives as humans living on Earth outside our habitable zone. It turns out that plants need certain conditions like sunlight intensity and temperature range to grow correctly. Therefore, if those conditions change drastically due to moving away from our star, many plants might no longer survive here. This means there may be no food anywhere near us, either locally grown or imported elsewhere. Health. If the Earth were closer to the sun, temperatures at the Earth's surface would rise significantly, which could have various health effects. Some of these effects are dehydration. With higher temperatures, the body loses water through sweat, which can lead to dehydration if not replaced properly. Heat-related illnesses. Extreme heat can cause several illnesses, including heat exhaustion and heat stroke. Infectious diseases. High temperatures and humidity can favor the proliferation of microorganisms such as bacteria, viruses, and fungi, which increases the risk of infections. Respiratory problems. High temperatures can increase the number of pollutants in the air, such as ozone and fine particles, which can worsen symptoms of respiratory diseases such as asthma and bronchitis. Radiation cancer. Being closer to the sun would also mean that we would receive higher doses of UV radiation, from which our atmosphere cannot protect us. So being closer to the sun would also cause an increase in skin cancer cases worldwide. On the other hand, if the Earth were further from the sun, temperatures would drop and have health effects such as hypothermia. Shallow temperatures can lead to hypothermia, a condition in which the body loses heat faster than it can produce. Respiratory diseases. Low temperatures can worsen the symptoms of respiratory diseases such as asthma and bronchitis. Cardiovascular diseases. Low temperatures can increase the risk of cardiovascular diseases since they can affect blood pressure and blood flow. Depression. Lack of sunlight can affect mood and increase the risk of depression. It is important to note that exposure to extreme heat and cold can be hazardous to your health, and taking steps to protect yourself in both cases is essential. Effects on animal life. The Earth's climate is a delicate balance between the sun's energy and the planet's atmosphere. If that balance were to be disrupted, it would have drastic consequences for animal life on Earth. This could cause significant changes in rainfall patterns worldwide. Some regions might get drier while others become wetter. Scientists believe this change could lead to mass extinctions among plants and animals living in those areas. Many species may not be able to adapt quickly enough before they are pushed out of their habitats by rising sea levels or other factors related to climate change. The most vulnerable would be insects. The increase or decrease in temperature in recent years has negatively affected the insect population in various ways, leading to its decline. Some of these ways include changes in the life cycle. With the change in temperatures, the life cycle of insects accelerates, which means that they complete their development faster and spend less time in intermediate stages. This can reduce their ability to feed, reproduce, and survive. Changes in geographic distribution. The change in temperatures has also led to changes in the geographic distribution of insects, as some prefer warmer climates and others cooler ones. This can lead to the local extinction of some species or the invasion of new areas by others. Habitat loss. The difference in temperatures has also led to habitat loss for the insects, as the areas where they used to live become less suitable for survival. Changes in interaction with other organisms. Changes in temperatures have also affected the interactions between insects and other organisms, such as plants and the animals that depend on them. For example, some studies suggest that butterflies and bees emerge earlier in the spring. Still, the plants that depend on them are not flowering simultaneously, which may affect their ability to obtain food. Changes in length of years and seasons. The decline in the insect population is generally concerning because insects are essential to keep ecosystems functioning correctly. They are important pollinators, decomposers, and food sources for many other animals. Declining insect populations can also affect food security and the economy, as many plant and crop species depend on them for pollination. In a colder or warmer world, the insects would be the first to die, and there would be nothing we could do to prevent it. The length of the years and the seasons on Earth are determined by its orbit around the sun. If the Earth were closer to or further from the sun, this would impact its orbit and therefore the length of years and seasons. Some of the possible effects in each scenario are described below. Earth closest to the sun. Shorter year. If the Earth were closer to the sun, its orbit would be shorter, and therefore the year would be shorter. The length of the seasons could also change, but this would depend on other factors such as the tilt of the Earth's axis. Changes in the seasons. If the Earth were closer to the sun, this could affect the length and intensity of the seasons. The warmer seasons could be longer and more intense, while the colder seasons could be shorter and less intense. Earth farthest from the sun. Longer year. If the Earth were farther from the sun, its orbit would be longer and therefore the year would be longer. Changes in the seasons. If the Earth were farther from the sun, the colder seasons could be longer and more intense, while the warmer seasons could be shorter and less intense. It is important to note that the length of years and seasons on Earth are the result of a combination of complex factors, and that the exact effects of distance from the sun can vary depending on other factors, such as the tilt of the axis of Earth and the shape of its orbit. Effects on the oceans. The oceans are the largest ecosystems on Earth, comprising about 70% of its surface area. They play a crucial role in regulating climate and weather patterns, absorbing carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, providing food for millions of people worldwide and serving as home to countless species of marine life. The impact of climate change on oceanic ecosystems is difficult to predict because each ecosystem responds differently depending on its location and species composition. However, there are several general predictions we can make based on what we know about how climate affects Earth's oceans. Sea levels will rise due to melting ice caps at both poles and possibly glaciers, flooding coastal areas worldwide. This could lead to increased flooding during storms or even permanent inundation if sea levels continue rising. Ocean acidification caused by increased CO2 levels may harm coral reefs. However, this effect is less specific than other possible impacts because we don't have enough data yet. Coral bleaching events could become more common due to warmer temperatures. Comparing Earth with other planets in the habitable zone, such as Venus and Mars, can help understand why life only developed on Earth. Venus, for example, is a planet in the habitable zone of the Sun, but its surface is boiling due to its dense atmosphere composed mainly of carbon dioxide. The average temperature on the surface of Venus is around 460 degrees Celsius, which is too hot for life as we know it to survive. Also, the high atmospheric pressure and lack of water on the surface make it very difficult for life to thrive on Venus. On the other hand, Mars is also in the Sun's habitable zone, but its atmosphere is much thinner than Earth's, making the surface temperature too cold for life as we know it. Additionally, the surface of Mars is exposed to cosmic radiation and intense solar activity, making it difficult for life to thrive. In short, the habitable zone is just one factor that influences a planet's ability to support life, but not the only one. The presence of liquid water, a suitable atmosphere, and a suitable temperature are just some other factors crucial to life as we know it. Earth is a unique planet in our solar system that meets all these requirements, allowing us to survive and thrive. The fact that Earth is in the habitable zone of our solar system is one of nature's greatest gifts. This range of temperature and distance from the Sun allows for the existence of life as we know it, and we must appreciate and care for it. Imagining a scenario where Earth is outside the habitable zone is terrifying, but also an invitation to reflect on how valuable our world is.